Welcome to Eye on the Tigers News. I'm Bianca Bros. Thanks for beginning your week with us for the news we've been watching for you. Police continue to investigate a possible motive in the latest deadly school shooting that left 10 people dead and several wounded on Friday. The mother of one of the 10 people killed at a Texas high school said her daughter recently rejected the romantic advances of the 17-year-old charged in the shootings, a possible motive for the violent tragedy. Sadie Rodriguez said her daughter, Shayna Fisher, had made clear that she was not interested in the teenage gunman. The junior suspect hid a shotgun and a handgun under his trench coat before opening fire in a first period art class on Friday, according to an affidavit filed by police. The FBI announced Saturday that it had taken the lead in a joint investigation at the request of local authorities. Santa Fe High School seniors are marking the end of their graduating year with a baccalaureate service 2 days after a gunman killed 10 on their Houston area campus. Pomp and circumstance played Sunday evening as the seniors filed into the pews of Arcadia First Baptist Church. Hundreds of parents and siblings applauded. Some of the graduates offered small smiles to people they knew. The baccalaureate service was moved from Santa Fe High School's auditorium because of the shooting. President Donald Trump says that he will demand that the Justice Department open an investigation to whether the FBI infiltrated his presidential campaign. The extraordinary order on Sunday came hours before his legal team said that the special counsel indicated its investigation into the president could be concluded by September. The Justice Department said later it had asked its internal watchdog to expand its existing probe of FBI actions. Trump's demand is part of the White House's aggressive new strategy to combat the threat posed by Special Counsel Robert Mueller's ongoing investigation into the Russia probe. The United States and China are pulling back from the brink of a trade war after the world's two biggest economies reported progress in talks aimed at bringing down America's massive trade deficit with Beijing. "We are putting the trade war on hold," Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin said Sunday. After high-level talks Thursday and Friday in Washington, Beijing agreed in a joint statement with the U.S. to substantially reduce America's trade deficit with China, but did not commit to cut the gap by any specific amount. The Trump administration had sought to slash the deficit by $200 billion. A volcano that is oozing, spewing, and exploding on Hawaii's Big Island has gotten more hazardous, spending rivers of molten rock pouring into the ocean Sunday and launching lava skyward that caused the first major injury. Kilauea volcano began erupting more than 2 weeks ago and has burned dozens of homes, forced thousands of people to flee, and shot up ash clouds from its summit that led officials to distribute face masks. Lava flows have picked up speed in recent days, spattering molten rock that hit a man in the leg. Deadpool and his foul-mouthed crew of misfits and malcontents have taken down the Avengers. Fox's Deadpool 2 brought in $125 million this weekend, giving it the second-highest opening ever for an R-rated movie and ending the three-week reign of Disney's Avengers: The Infinity War. At the top of the North American box office, according to studio estimates Sunday, Deadpool 2, with Ryan Reynolds returning as the title character and co-writer this time, fell somewhat short of the $130 million the studio predicted and the $132.4 million that his predecessor earned 2 years ago. Analysts and the studio said that the difference can be attributed to the first film opening on a holiday weekend and could easily be made up with the Memorial Day coming, despite the looming competition from Solo, a Star Wars story. "We're enjoying a beautiful day today, and the weather looks great for the week, except for a minor blip for Tuesday. Here's Matt with the forecast."
We've got lots of sunshine on tap for the rest of our Monday, before some clouds roll in tonight, bringing some occasional rain showers. Rain sticks around early Tuesday before another new system makes its way to the area. That new system could spark some thunderstorms Tuesday afternoon. The good news is high pressure works its way in for the rest of the week, bringing sunshine and very comfortable temperatures. In fact, we could be looking at a stretch of at least four great days beginning with Wednesday, with gradually warming temperatures. That's the forecast. I'm Matt. Have a great day.
Mm-hmm.
The Warriors routed the Rockets to take a 2-1 series lead. Here's Ashley with sports. Stephen Curry shook, shimmied, and screamed, letting his adoring fans and the Rockets know that Oracle Arena was his house. Once the two-time MVP got his groove back, Houston was helpless. Curry scored 35 points with 5 three-pointers, shooting over James Harden and driving past him as the Golden State Warriors made a second-half statement to beat the Rockets 126-85 on Sunday night with a 2-1 lead in the Western Conference Finals. Curry had 18 points on 7-for-7 shooting in the third quarter, lying with his back flat on the court for a unique version of a snow angel. The series continues Tuesday. In the Eastern Finals, Cleveland and Boston are back in it tonight, with the Celtics leading the series 2-1 after Cleveland got in the win column on Saturday. Congratulations go out to the Lemoyne College women's lacrosse team, which captured the national championship on Sunday, defeating powerhouse Florida Southern 16-11. It's the first national championship for the women's program. Mexico baseball is headed to the Section 3 playoffs, where they'll face Marcellus on Monday afternoon. The Tigers are seeded 20th and Marcellus 13th. Because of the terrible spring weather, sectional play is open this year. The Lady Tiger softball team is also seeded 20th, and they'll travel to Jordan Elbridge today for a first-round game. And finally, congratulations to the Mexico boys 4x800-meter relay team for breaking the school record last Friday night at the Beeville Invitational. Troy Brown, Daniel Gowans, Wyatt Jensen, and Kyle Higby successfully broke the record by 2 seconds with a time of 8:35.56. Our sectional meet is this Thursday in West Hill. That's a look at sports. Have a great day. I'm Ashley. Summer driver education signups are today for sophomores. Come to Student Services to sign up. Last date for sports physicals is tomorrow, Tuesday, May 22nd, in the nurse's office. This is the only time physicals will be offered for fall sports. Senior dinner dance tickets are now on sale. The price is $50, and you can get your tickets from Mr. McKenna or Mr. McGiff. Senior dinner dance is June 8th from 7 to 11 at the American Foundry. That is it for us today. Thanks for being with us. I'm Bianca Burrows. Have a great rest of your day.